Hello students, my name is Anthony sir and today we are going to learn this very good lesson, The Little Girl, and I'm sure that all of you know about this lesson because we have learned this lesson in class 8 also. Okay, so I'm making this video for both class 8 and class 9 because the lesson is the same and the explanation is also the same. Good, and we have the author. The name of the author is Catherine. Okay, she has written this lesson very nice, and in this lesson we understand the feeling of a girl. Normally the children, they have a certain kind of opinion in their mind about their parents, what kind of parents they have. Some children, they really like their parents very much. Some children, they don't like their parents, they like others' parents. It means when children are comparing their parents with other parents, then they make certain opinion in their mind. And that is the same thing that we are going to understand here. Okay? So let's see what is in the lesson. The name of the lesson is The Little Girl. Before you read, do you feel you know your parents better now than when you were much younger? I think you understand your parents better now, because when you were small, you always thought that your daddy is a superman. But as you grew, you realized that no, daddy is not really a superman, he is a human being. Okay, perhaps you now understand the reason for some of their actions that used to upset you earlier. Okay, so as your understanding is increasing, you understand that why your father or why your mother behaves in a certain way. This story about a little girl whose feeling for her father changed from fear to understanding will probably find an echo in every home. So in this lesson we will understand the mindset of a little girl called Kezia towards her father and how the mindset has changed from fear to understanding the father better. Okay, now I start the lesson. To the little girl, he was a figure to be feared and avoided. Figure to be feared means a person to be feared. So that little girl, she was avoiding her father because her father was quite a frightening personality. Every morning before going to work, he came into her room and gave her a casual kiss. So every morning he will come and give a casual means normal kiss, to which she responded with goodbye father, and she has to respond what? Goodbye daddy, father. And oh, there was a glad sense of relief when she heard the noise of carriage. Here carriage is actually the car, we can say for now, but if this lesson is very old, it means we can say the horse cart. Okay, so the carriage growing fainter and faint. It means the voice of that vehicle is becoming small and small down the long road. It means the father is going away. In the evening when he came home, she stood near the staircase and heard his loud voice in the hall. Now in the evening when he come back from the office, he is quite angry, so that is why Kezia will hear the loud voice of daddy, and the voice says, "Bring my tea into the drawing room. Hasn't the paper come yet? Mother, go and see if my papers out there, and bring my slippers." It means he will command to do certain things when he come back from work. And that is the reason why Kezia was quite afraid, because he used to shout a lot. Kezia, mother would call her too. Mother would now give some responsibility to Kezia. So she will call, "If you are a good girl, you can come down and take off father's boot." So that was her work, to remove father's shoes. Slowly, the girl would slip down the stairs, more slowly, still across the hall, and pushed open the drawing room door. Okay, she was quite afraid. That is why, quite slowly, she will come. Quite slowly, slip down. It means in an unwilling manner. Okay. By that time, he had his spectacles on and looked at her over them. So as he is wearing the spectacle, he will bring the spectacle down and he will see her over the spectacle, just to frighten somebody. Okay, in a way that was terrifying to the little girl, and that was actually terrifying thing to Kezia. "Well, Kezia, hurry up and pull off these boots and take them outside." So he will shout on Kezia that remove the shoes and take them outside. "Have you been a good girl today?" It means, "Were you a good girl today?" Then she would shudder. Then she said, I don't know, father." Okay, then father gets angry and say, You don't know? "If you shudder like that, mother will have to take you to the doctor." Shudder means stammering. If you have that stammering tongue, then I will tell mother to take you to the hospital. Then mother will also reply, "She never shuddered with other people." It means she doesn't stammer with other people. "She had quite given it up, but only with father." It means she is shuddering only with father because of the fear. Because then she was trying so hard to say the words properly. That time she was shuddering because she wanted to speak the words very clearly. And she is a child. That is why she was not able to say it properly, but shuddering or stammering voice. "What's the matter? What are you looking so wretched about, mother? I wish you taught this child not to appear on the brink of suicide." What is the meaning of brink of suicide? It means about to commit suicide. So he will talk to Kezia, and then he will ask, "What is the problem?" And then he will also, the daddy will tell the mommy that why this girl looks like she is at the brink of suicide, she is about to commit suicide. "Here, Kezia, carry my teacup back to the table carefully." Then he will give the teacup and tell her to put it on the table. He was so big. This is the description of Kezia about her daddy. "He was so big, his hands and his neck, especially his mouth when he yawned." Yawn means when you open the mouth, you can see that his mouth is also big. "Thinking about him alone was like thinking about a giant." Okay, giant means a big, huge, huge man. Okay. "On Sunday afternoons, grandmother sent her down to the drawing room to have a nice talk with father and mother." So it was actually grandmother who used to force her to go and talk with mom and dad. "But the little girl always found mother reading and father stretched out on the sofa." That you can see it on the picture. In the picture, mother is reading something, magazine or something, and daddy is lying on sofa with the pillow on his face. Okay. It is handkerchief rather. But the little, okay. "His handkerchief on his face, his feet on one of the best cushion," means a cushion, pillow. Okay. He will put his leg on it, sleeping soundly and snoring. Soundly means very good sleep. Nobody can wake him up, that is called soundly. And snoring. Snoring is the noise that we make in the sleep, that is called snoring. Next page. "She sat on a stool, gravely watched him until he woke and stretched and asked the time, then looked at her." Okay? Gravely, she was standing there, and when daddy woke up, he asked the time. To who? To Kezia. "Don't stare so, Kezia, you look like a little brown owl." Okay, so daddy was actually teasing her, getting angry on her, and he said that you look like a little brown owl. "One day, when she was kept indoors with a cold, her grandmother told her that father's birthday was next week." So she was in the house, in the room, and it was very cold, and the grandmother said that it is daddy's birthday next week, and suggested that she should make him a pin cushion for a gift out of a beautiful piece of yellow silk. So the suggestion was given to her that she should make a pillow, a cushion, and give daddy a gift on his birthday. Laboriously means with lot of effort and difficulties. "With a double cotton, the little girl stitched three sides of the pillow." Okay, one side should be open so that you can put some stuff inside. Normally we put cotton in it. "But what to fill it with?" Now the question is, what to put inside the pillow case? That was the question. The grandmother was out in the garden, and she wandered into mother's bedroom to look for scraps. Okay, so Kezia was looking for something, some scrap that she can put it in the pillow. On the bed table, she discovered a great many sheets of fine paper, gathered them up and tore them into tiny pieces and stuffed her case, then sewed up the fourth side. Now what she did? She found some paper, some lot of paper on the table, and she took them, tore into pieces, and then she stuffed the papers into the case, and then she sewed the fourth side of the pillow. That night there was a hue and cry. What is the meaning of hue and cry? It means angry. Everybody was angry in the house. Father's great speech for the port authority had been lost. Okay, that night daddy had prepared a very nice speech that he supposed to give to the port authority, but it has been lost. Rooms were searched, every room was searched. Servants questioned, they asked questions to servant also. Finally, mother came into Kezia's room. Now that time mother came to Kezia's room and she asked, Kezia, I suppose you didn't see some paper on a table in our room. She asked the question actually. Then Kezia, with very innocent voice, she said, oh yes, she said, I tore them up for my surprise. Oh, the surprise is very big, because it was very important paper and she tore them into pieces. Then she screamed. What? Screamed mother. Come straight down to the dining room this instant. This instant means right now. Okay. And she was dragged down to where father was pacing to and fro. Pacing to and fro means walking to and fro here and there. Hands behind his back. Very worried. This kind of picture that you can see it in the movie, especially old movies, where angry man, his hands back and he's moving here and there. Well, he said sharply, mother, explain. He stopped and stared at the child. Did you do that? And the answer, no, she whispered. Mother, go up to her room and fetch down the damn thing. Damn thing here means whatever things that was taken by Kezia, go and bring it. See that the child's put to bed this instant. Okay, now daddy is angry and then say, go and make him to sleep. Next, crying too much to explain, she lie in the shadowed room. Shadow means dark room, watching the evening light make a sad little pattern on the floor. Okay, it was a quite sad light in her room in that evening, and she was drawing some pattern on the floor with the little finger. Okay, then father came into the room with the ruler in his hand. Now he came with the stick, the ruler. Okay, I'm going to beat you for this, he said. Oh no, she screamed, hiding under the bedclothes. She hid herself under the bedclothes. Okay, a kind of bedsheet. Then he pulled them aside. Sit up, he ordered, and hold out your hands. You must be taught once. You must be taught once means today I'm going to beat you so that you will remember forever and for all not to touch what does not belong to you. It means this is the lesson you will learn, that next time don't touch anything that does not belong to you. But it was for your birthday. The answer he got that Kezia is saying it was for your birthday. Down came the ruler on her little pink palm. It means she got beaten. Hours later, when grandmother had wrapped her in a shawl and rocked her means move her, okay, move her so that you don't cry. Okay, yeah, there is a rocking chair also, moving chair. Okay, so she put her in a shawl and moving her in her rocking chair. The child clung to her soft body. Clung means to hold it tightly. Okay, she was holding the grandma's body. Very tight hug. What did God make fathers for? Now she is angry, so she has so many questions and she cannot ask to father, so she is asking these questions to God. Then say, why, what did God made fathers for? She sob. Sob means crying. After crying, the noise that we make, that is called sob. Here is a clean hanky, darling, blow your nose, go to sleep. Blow your nose here, it means clean. After crying, you see, you're supposed to remove the stuff from your nose to clean it and then go to sleep. Pet, you will forget all about it in the morning. It means whatever happened today, you will forget in the morning, so go and sleep. I tried to explain the father, but he was too upset to listen tonight. So grandmother also said that I also tried to explain to your daddy, but he was quite upset. That is why he did not listen. But the child never forgot. Next time she saw him, she quickly put both hands behind her back and a red color flew into her cheeks. Okay, red color flew her into cheeks. It means this time she got beating on the cheek. Okay, the McDonald lived next door. Now here the twist comes in the story. Another story. Okay, is we can say part two of the story. So in that story, another character that has been introduced, his name is McDonald. He lived next door. He was their neighbor. They had five children. Looking through a gap in the fence, the little girl saw them playing tag in the evening. Now, for you to understand this sentence, you can see it in the picture. You see the fence there, and she is watching from this fence that Mr. McDonald is playing with his five children. Back to the lesson. Mao on his shoulder, one of the child is called Mao. He was on the shoulder. Two little girls hanging on to his coat pocket ran round and round the flower bed, shaking with laughter. Okay, to understand this one also, you can see the picture. You can see the children, they are holding the daddy's clothes, jacket. One is on the shoulder and they are going round and round and they are happy. And once she saw the boys turn the hose on him and he tried to catch them laughing all the time. Okay, hose means the trouser that he is wearing. One of the boy was pulling the trouser and they were trying to catch each other. Then she decided that there were different sorts of father. Okay, so looking at this picture, in her mind she decided that there are different type of fathers in this world. Some are good, some are bad. That is what she thought in the mind. Suddenly one day mother became ill and she and grandmother went to the hospital. They went to the hospital, who? Mother and grandmother. The little girl was left alone in the house with Alice. Now Alice, who is Alice? She is the maid, a worker, a cook in the house. So she was alone there with Alice. That was all right in the daytime. Daytime it was okay, nobody was afraid. But while Alice was putting her to bed, it means when they were going to sleep, she grew suddenly afraid. She became very afraid. Okay, now remember, who is not in the house? Mother and grandmother is not in the house, and father is there, and Alice, the cook, she is also there. What will I do if I have a nightmare? She asked the question to Alice. She asked, I often have a nightmare. What is the meaning of nightmare? It means a very bad, horrible dream. That is called nightmare. And then Granny takes me into her bed. So whenever she used to get nightmare, Granny will take her into her bed and she becomes bit okay. I can't stay in the dark. It all gets whispery. Whispery means the sound that you are hearing in the night. You just go to sleep, child, said Alice, pulling off her socks. Okay, so she took out the socks and said, just go to sleep. And don't you scream and wake your poor pa. Okay, and say, don't scream in the night. Otherwise, your daddy here, the word is used, poor pa. Poor here doesn't mean very, he doesn't have money. But poor means he is very tired. So don't wake him up. Next. But the same old nightmare came. Now when she was sleeping, she got a dream. And what is the dream? In the dream, she saw the butcher with a knife and a rope, who came nearer and nearer, smiling that dreadful smile, while she could not move, could only stand still, crying out, Grandma, Grandma. Now in that dream, there is a butcher. Butcher means somebody who kills the animal. So butcher with his knife and rope, he was coming and laughing a dreadful smile. Dreadful means horrible smile. And Kezia was there in the dream and she was crying. And in the dream she was crying, Grandma, Grandma, help me. She woke up shivering to see father beside her bed. And she woke up, and when she woke up, she saw the father there, a candle in his hand, and he was holding a candle. What is the matter? He said. Now the father asked, she was actually not expecting a father to come and help her, so that is why she was surprised and she saw the daddy there. Daddy even asked, what is the matter, baby? A butcher, a knife, I want granny. So she wasn't able to explain the whole dream. She just said, a butcher, a knife, I want grandma. He blew out the candle, bent down and caught up the child in his arm. So he wanted to comfort her. That is why he took her in his arm, carrying her along the passage to the big bedroom. He took her to the big bedroom. That is where he was sleeping. A newspaper was on the bed. He put away the paper, then carefully tucked up the child. It means he put the baby there on the bed and covered her with the bed sheet. That is called tuck up the child. He lay down beside her and then he slept beside her, half asleep still. He was not sleeping fully. That is called half asleep still. Still with a butcher smile all about her, it seemed, she crept close to him. She was even afraid there also, because in that place also she was watching the butcher who was smiling. So she crept close. What is the meaning of crept close? Means to crawl and go somewhere. So she went to him, snugging her head under his arm. She put her head under the arm. Snuggle means to move into a warm and comfortable place. Okay? And held tightly to his shirt, and she was holding him tightly. Then the dark did not matter. Now she was not afraid. What is the meaning of dark did not matter? Means she was not afraid of the darkness because she can see that daddy is there. Here, rub your feet against my legs and get your warmth. Okay, so he was warm in the bed. That is why he said that rub your bed here and you will become warm. Because remember, this story is from European country where the weather is very, very cold. Then, tired out, she was tired. He slept before the little girl. The daddy slept. A funny feeling came over her. Now she had a kind of funny feeling. Why? Because she was always thinking that daddy is bad, but now she has another feeling. Then she said, poor father, not so big after all. So after she was able to hold him and hug him, then all her mindset, all the view that he is very big, his hands are big, his neck is big, his mouth is big, then he said that no, it is not actually big. And with no one to look after him, it means nobody is there to take care of him at this point, because mummy and grandma, they are in the hospital. He was harder than grandmother, but it was a nice hardness. It means the body of him, it was harder than grandmother, but it was okay. It was a good thing. And every day he had to work and was too tired to be a Mr. McDonald. Now she understood that because he gets very tired from his work and hard day, he cannot become Mr. McDonald. She had torn up all his beautiful writing. So now she could remember that it was her mistake that she torn all the writing. She stood suddenly and sighed. And then she just started sighed, feeling little bit bad. What is the matter? Asked her father. Daddy asked, what is the problem? Then she said, another dream has come. Then she said, oh, said the little girl. Daddy said, oh, my head is on your heart. Okay, my head is put on the chest where the heart is. I can hear it going. It means I can hear that your heart is beating. What a big heart you have got, dear father. And then she said that, daddy, you have got a very good heart. When we say very big heart, it means very good heart for the children. Written by Catherine Mansfield. Okay, so this is what happened actually. When you want to understand your father and your mother, just give some time and you will see the nice part, the loving kindness of your daddy and your mother one day. Okay, so when your daddy and mommy is shouting on you and correcting you because of your mistake, don't judge your parents that they are very bad. No, they are not bad, but they just want to correct you because they know that in the world you are supposed to be corrected, otherwise you will become a very bad boy or a bad girl. So they correct, and when you accept that correction, and you will see that your parents are also very good parents than your neighbor's parents. Okay, so this is the lesson, and it's very good lesson. And try to understand the feeling of children and the feeling of parents and the busyness and hard work and the tiredness of father also. Okay, so this is the lesson. If you have any question, you can ask me on the group. And also I want to tell you one more thing. Please subscribe my channel, and before you watch it, please subscribe it. And also every day we have classes at 3:30 on Zoom, so I would like you to join the Zoom classes also. And if you have any question, you can ask me. My WhatsApp number is given in the comment. You can send me the message. Thank you so much. Bye bye.